Welcome back. In this video, we want to wrap up with the numeric data types. There are lots of operations that we can perform on the numeric data types. For example, if you want to find the absolute value of a certain number, we can use the app function, that is abx, then we pass in the value that we want to find the absolute of. So we can put in here negative, let's say 10, and then if we run this, we get positive 10. Remember, if you are using a different IDE other than this Jupyter Notebook, you have to bring the print function here, all right, in order to print it. Then you print this, you get the same thing. All right. Also, if you want to find the minimum or maximum between a list of numbers, you can use the maximum function or the minimum function. So if you do this mass, then we pass in some numbers, let's say 1, 1.5, let's say 3. It can take as many arguments as you want. All right, so if you print this, you get 3 as the maximum number. The only number that we can compare here is complex numbers. All right, we can compare the integers and the floating point numbers. Also, if you want to find the mean between some numbers, you can pass in some numbers here. If you run this, we are getting the minimum number as 3. Also, if you want to find the power of some numbers, let's say you want to find 2 raised to the power 3, we can use the power function, that is POW. Then you pass in the base. The base comes in first, all right? So our base here is 2. So 2, then the exponent comes in second. If you run this, we get 8. Also, we can run some numbers to a certain decimal places that we want, using the round function. So if we use the round function as this, then the first argument is the number that you want to round off, let's say 0.6789. Then the second argument will be the number of decimal places that we want. So if you want 2 decimal places here, we bring 2. If we run this, it rounds off to 2 decimal places. Remember, if you don't bring the second argument, it will run off to the nearest whole number. So let's copy this and then let's paste it here. Let's remove the second parameter. That is, we are not specifying the number of decimal places that we want. It will automatically run off to the nearest whole number. So that is how the round function works. There are lots of mathematical operations that we can perform on the numeric data type. So if you want to do some higher mathematical operations, we can use a built-in math function, all right, that Python has. But before you use it, we will have to import the math function first. We will learn importation of modules and packages in later lessons, but for now, let's see what the math module has for us. Okay, so before we can use it, we have to run this import math. Then there are a lot of things that is in the math module. So before we can see what the math function has, we can use the dir, that is the directory of the math function, and then see all the functions that it has. So let's print this, and we can see a lot of functions here. You can find a GCD, inf is closed, but this is not giving us, this is just listing us the packages that it has, all right, the functions that it has. But we want to see what actually each of them does. So we can use the help function. And then if we run this, we can see that now we have what a description of what each and every one of the functions does. So let's try to maximize this a little. And then we can see that we have arcsine, arccos, and then lots of operations here. Can find a combination of some numbers. So let's try and do some. Say combining number of ways to choose k items from items, without repetitive and without all that. Let's try to find a combination of, let's say, so we have to type it this way, math.com. It bring, let's say, 6 combination 2. And if you run this, you are getting 15, all right? So we can do a lot of things here. Let's see another thing that we can use. We can find the sqrt, that return the square root of x. So let's try to find the sqrt. So math.sql, remember that you have to bring the math. So SQRT of, let's say, 25, we expect 5, right? Yes, 5.0. It's giving us a float number. There are a lot of things here. You use it when you need it. You see, there is the power function that you use is also in the math module. I'll leave this for you to explore. You use it when you need it. There are a lot of things here. And when we are doing scientific computing with Python, you use a lot of these. So we'll end there. And then our next topic will be the strange data type. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.